Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 30th May, on the front page, the news items are political regarding ministerial appointments which will take place, and this is regarding state legislative assembly elections also, which were held simultaneously with Lok Sabha elections. So in Orisha and Arunachal Pradesh, the CMs have been sworn in, that is Naveen Patnaik of Biju Janata Dal, who has been sworn in as the CM of Odisha, and in Arunachal Pradesh it is Pema Khandu, who has been sworn as Chief Minister of Arunachal Pradesh. Mr. Naveen Patnaik is taking oath for the Chief Minister of Odisha for the fifth consecutive term. Then below you have Kargil war veteran declared a foreigner. So this is a family of a retired soldier who fought in the Kargil war 2 decades ago. It has approached the Guwahati High Court, less than 24 hours after he was sent to detention center for foreigners or illegal migrants. So he retired as honorary lieutenant in the army and has been arrested soon after. This is in context of NRC exercise in Assam, National Register of Citizens. On page 2, you have Payal Tadvi death case leaves medical fraternity divided. So this is death of Mumbai resident Dr. Payal Tadvi, who allegedly committed suicide due to caste-based harassment from a senior doctors as such. So this has shocked the community of doctors, and Indian Medical Association calls it an isolated case, but other health networks term this incident institutional murder. So it's a kind of ragging, it is said, and there's a need for stringent action taken. On page 4 you have Delhi Jal Board approves new water treatment plant. So this is construction of a drinking water treatment plant in Chandrawal at a cost of 598 crore rupees, and another plant which is to be set up in Okhla. It is said to be the India's biggest sewage treatment plant. It is 1161 crore plant, which will likely be completed by June 2022. So this is the detail of it given to. On page 5 you have NGT directs Railway Board to look into plea on pollution. So this is a plea in petition in the National Green Tribunal seeking remedial action against pollution around a railway ground in UP's Faizabad godown. So this is a railway godown. So NGT has directed Railway Board to look into the matter. So it is said that loading unloading from goods train here affects and causes air pollution. It affects the air quality. On page 8 you have Gaganyaan astronaut training pact finalized. So Indian Air Force and Indian Space Research Organization have signed an MOU for imparting training to Indian astronauts for ISRO's Gaganyaan program. So the both institutions would work together, you can see. So it will be IAF's Bengaluru based medical arm and ISRO's Institute of Aerospace Medicine which will jointly work on this. So it will train the first set of Indian astronauts. So Gaganyaan, you should know, it plans to send humans in space by 2022, the 75th year of Indian independence. And this is power poles shifted to make way for statue. So steps have been taken to ensure smooth journey of this massive Vishnu statue, which will be installed. It's a 64-foot statue which will be installed at Kothandrama Swami temple in Bengaluru. So for this, power poles have been shifted, that is 35 electric poles are being shifted, footpaths are cleared and few houses have been demolished. So this on page 9 you have registration software helps unearth illegal abortions in Tiruvannamalai. So this is a tip off which came from public health center medical officer who asked village health nurse to visit a registered woman who had not turned up for antenatal checkup for 8 weeks. So when there is registration of all women who are pregnant, and when the women are supposed to come for regular checkups and they didn't come turn up for checkup, finding about it, it came to know that the illegal abortion has been conducted. Below you have 84 cities submit plans for improving air quality by 2024. So 84 out of 102 cities that have been tasked with reducing toxic particulate matter pollution by 20-30% by 2024 have submitted the proposals. So that is the National Clean Air Program, which we have been discussing quite often. So center plans period review ahead of the environment day 2, that is on 5th June. On the editorial page, the first editorial is the second coming. So this is regarding the invitation list for swearing in for Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So it says this signals the foreign policy of the government, foreign policy focus. And this is a cup to win. So this is regarding the ICC World Cup, so which is going to commence now. So it says it's anyone's game at the ICC World Cup, but India would fancy its chances. The lead article, breaking out of the middle growth orbit. So this article says that the second Modi government faces a challenging economic agenda. It must back key reforms. So this talks about how there are reforms required, like rescuing the non-banking finance companies and, you know, boosting consumption. So reforms are required, and how the government goes ahead, it would play a key role. And this is why the integrity of data matters. So this is regarding the merger of National Sample Survey Organization and the Central Statistics Office. So this merger, the article says, is a cause of concern because the integrity of data is being questioned, and the merger, what exactly the merger means, has remained unclear. On page 13, you have GST evasion, Supreme Court to examine power of authorities to make arrest. So this is regarding the issue of GST evasion. So whether arrest can take place in such cases is a question for the Supreme Court, on which it would decide. It has also sought the central government's response on this. The 3-judge bench of the Supreme Court is hearing this case. On international page, you have that continuing news of Iran-US tensions. And here you have Johnson faces court hearing over Brexit lies. So this is Boris Johnson, the front runner to become the Britain's next Prime Minister after Theresa May steps down. Now he must attend a court hearing over allegations that he knowingly lied during the Brexit referendum campaign. So it is said that he said the case is over the claim that Britain sends 350 million euros, a week to the European Union. So this is said to be a lie. So he repeatedly lied and misled the British public as to the cost of EU membership. And below you have 18 killed in Taliban strike near Jam Minaret. So this is the Jam Minaret, which is said to be the world's second tallest brick tower. So Taliban fighters have stormed many security posts providing protection to Afghanistan's historic minaret of Jam. So they have cut access to the UNESCO World Heritage Site, and 18 security forces officials have been killed. So this has happened in Afghanistan. On business page, you have RBI forms task force on corporate yields. So this is a step taken by RBI to develop secondary market. So this task force will suggest policy and regulatory interventions required for development of secondary market in corporate loans, including loan transaction platforms for stressed assets. And this is RBI panel on home finance securitization. So the RBI has constituted a committee to review the existing state of mortgage securitization in India and suggest measures to deepen it. So the mortgage securitization market in India is primarily dominated by direct assessment among the limited set of market participants. So this is because of various structural factors impacting both demand and supply side. So now a panel of RBI look into this matter. And this is banning us won't make networks more secure. So this is Huawei, which tells Trump. So this is the telecom company from China, which has been banned in various countries because of US insistence that it is a security threat. But it says that USA has shown no proof that Huawei is a security threat. On the last page, you have Mumbai writer Annie Zaidi wins $1 lakh global prize. So she's set to expand her award-winning essay into a book too now. So she writes it's an award, it's called 9 Dots Prize, which is an award for creative thinking that tackles contemporary societal issues. So she won the prize for her entry, Bread, Cement, Cactus, a piece that combined memoir and reportage of to explore concepts of home and belonging. And this is SpaceX satellite pose new headache for astronomers. So it says that the objects can interfere with the observations on SpaceX. So what is happening is that an astronomer in the Netherlands captured footage of a train of brightly lit SpaceX satellites ascending through the night sky. So this has provoked an outcry among astronomers who say the constellation, which so far consists of 60 broadband beaming satellites, could one day grow to as many as 12,000. So it may threaten the view of the cosmos and deal a blow to scientific discovery too. So this has become a cause of concern. And here you have a new species of wasp has been recently identified by scientists in Goa. Many such new species get identified. And this has been transgender is no longer a mental disorder, says World Health Organization. So World Health Organization will no longer categorize being transgender as a mental disorder. And finally, here you have India has 20 health workers for 10,000 people, study finds. So India has 20.6 health workers per 10,000 people, which is a ratio close to the World Health Organization threshold of 22.8. So this is according to the data from National Sample Survey. And this is regarding Mount Everest, ascent, the anniversary of Mount Everest ascent by Edwin Hillary and Tenzing Norgay. The summit peak was reached by them in 1953. So recently we have seen such cases of deaths taking place. We have discussed that in news yesterday, so you can skip this today. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.